Good day and welcome back. So today we're going to look at potentiometer and wisdom bridge. We are going to understand the working principle of potentiometer and wisdom bridge, and we're going to look at a few examples regarding potentiometer today. So first we look at the potentiometer. So it is a wire which is usually 1 meter long, and it is used to measure voltage by the comparison method. So you can connect the wire to an EMF source. And then the point C and D is connected to the source that you want to measure. To do that, you're going to move the slider, or also known as the jockey, between point A and B until you get a zero reading at galvanometer. From here, you can measure the length between A and S. So the length is referred as the balance length. When the reading at the galvanometer is zero, it means that the electric potential at point D and S is equal, and there is no current flow between point D and S. So balance length is the length where you get an equal potential, and the potential difference between point A and S is equal to the potential difference between point C and D. So the wire AB has linear resistance, which means the resistance is linearly proportional to the length of the wire. By using the formula of the potential divider, you can measure the voltage across point A and S, which is also equal to the potential difference between point C and D. They are equal to the ratio of the balance length to the total length of AB multiplied the total voltage. By using the potentiometer, it can provide more accurate result compared to the voltmeter. The reason that the voltmeter has lesser accuracy is that it has internal resistance that might affect the overall resistance of the circuit. So now we look at one of the examples to measure the EMF of a dry cell. So here I use a question from the trial 2019 Kelantan Module 1. So you are given with the circuit diagram. You have the driver cells of 4 volts and is connected to the 1 meter long resistance wire. So we are going to measure a cell of unknown EMF. So you are given with the balance length that equal to the 35 centimeter. So by using the formula of the potential divider, you can calculate the value of the EMF by the ratio of the 35 centimeter to the total length, 100 centimeter, multiply the total voltage, and you will get 1.4 volts. However, the result here is still not accurate yet because we still ignore the internal resistance of the 4 volt dry cell. Potentiometer can obtain accurate result by using a comparison method. So how we do that? We can connect another cell of non-EMF, and we do the comparison. For example, from the trial questions, you are given with a standard cell of EMF 1.18 volt and give you the balance length of 30.2 centimeter. So without considering the EMF or 4 volt voltage, we are going to compare the result of a non-EMF with the non-EMF. So I've explained that the resistance is proportional to the length of the wire. So we also can conclude that the voltage between point A and C is also proportional to the length of the wire. So by using this relation, so we can express the equations of the EMF over 1.18 watt equal to the respective length, which is the 35 over 30.2 centimeter. Solving this, you would get the EMF as 1.37 watt, which is more accurate. So besides measuring the EMF, so we also can measure the internal resistance of the cell by connecting a non-resistor in parallel to the EMF. When the galvanometer shows zero reading, so it means that there is no current flowing from the driver cell to the EMF. However, when you connect a resistor in parallel to the EMF, so there's a current flow through from the EMF to the resistor and then back to the EMF. So this situation is similar to the topic of the internal resistance that we have discussed before. So you have this circuit of the EMF with the internal resistance connected to a resistor in series. When there's a current flow in the circuit, so we learned that there's a voltage drop at the internal resistance of the EMF. To measure the potential difference, we can refer to the balance length at potentiometer. Let's say you are given with the balance length of 25 centimeter. From here, we can measure the potential difference equal to the 25 over 100 multiplied 4 volt, and you will get 1 volt. And then we're going to examine the circuit and find out the internal resistance based on the formula regarding the internal resistance that we've done before. So the EMF is equal to the current multiplied total resistance. From here, we will get the equations of 1.37 multiplied I multiplied R plus R. And then we also could have the equations of V equal to IR, where the 1 volt is equal to the current flow through the resistor. So let's say the resistor is 5 ohms. So we can divide the first equations with the second equations, and you could get this expression. Solving the equations would give you the value of the internal resistance, which is 1.85 ohm for this case. So you can try out another question from the trial, which is 2021 from SMK Yuhua, to do more practice regarding this topic. Next, we're going to look at another device, which is thermocouple. So thermocouple is a device that can generate EMF when there's temperature difference between the two junctions. So the maximum EMF produced by this device is usually very small, in the magnitude of few millivolts. So if we are going to use potentiometer to measure the EMF value, so the baseline obtained is usually very, very short. For example, we have a thermocouple that gives us the maximum reading of 1 milliwatt. When you apply the formula of the potential divider, so you will get a balance length of 0.05 centimeter. As a human, it is almost impossible for us to get the length of 0.05 centimeter on the potentiometer. To solve these problems, we can connect a resistor in series with the 2-volt driver cell so that we can divide the voltage between the wire AB and the resistor to maximize the balance length, which means we will get 1 milliwatt at 100 centimeter long. We will let the voltage across the resistor to be the remaining voltage, which is 1.999 watts. So let's say the wire AB is 10 ohm resistance. We can use the concept of the ratio that V is proportional to the resistance. We can build these equations of R over 10 equal to the 1.999 over 0.01 volt. And you can get the value of the resistor is 19.99 kilo ohm resistance. With this resistor, when the thermocouple generate the maximum EMF, we will get 100 centimeter of the balance length, which is achievable by the human compared to the 0.05 centimeter, which require more precise equipment to do that. Next, we're going to look at the Wheatstone bridge, which is almost similar to the potentiometer. Instead of using the wire AB, so Wheatstone bridge use two known resistance, a variable resistance to measure the resistance of the unknown resistor by using the comparison method. So we know the resistance of the P and Q. So we adjust the variable resistance until the reading of the galvanometer equal to zero. At zero reading, there's no current flow through between point A and B, and the electric potential at point A and B are equal. This means that the potential difference across the resistor P and R are equal. Also, the potential difference across the resistor Q and S are also equal. Using the relationship of the voltage proportional to the resistance, we can have the equations of the VP over VQ is equal to P over Q, and they are equal to the ratio of the R to S. With this, we can measure the unknown resistance by using the ratio of P to Q, multiply the resistance of the S when the galvanometer shows zero reading. So this is quite a straightforward topic that I will not cover the example of the Wheatstone bridge. So if you need me to further discuss on these two topics, so you can fill in the Google form to let me know, or you can leave it in the comment section below and we can have further discussion there. So that's all for my video. So do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.